Hey guys, Joe McCray here from Infosecaddicts doing another edition of Mentor Moment. This probably should be Joe on the Road. If you haven't seen my Joe on the Road series, check here. I'm at LAX airport right now, and there's nobody here, so I figured why not make a video. It's 3:30 in the morning, waiting for my connecting flight. What I wanted to talk to you guys about was Python 3. And for me, I think Python 3, it was something I was reluctant to move to. I've been doing so much Python over the years. I was really, really reluctant to move to it, but man. Now that we've made the change of migrating all the content to Python 3, I learned a lot. And quite frankly, I don't know why I fought it for so long. Now that we've made that move, I was so reluctant because I felt like all the reference material and all the examples of other tools were all written in Python 2. So I felt like it was hard for the students to learn because there wasn't a lot of reference code for them to look at in Python 3. You know, scanners, sniffers, brute forcers. And when I'm teaching, that's usually what I tell the students to look at. Look at how this other guy wrote a sniffer. Look at how this other guy wrote a brute forcer. And since there's so much of that content in Python 2x, I felt like, well, for a person trying to learn, they should stay in 2x. I was teaching a class and I actually got a bad review because the student was really upset that we weren't covering Python 3. I kept trying to say, well, look, you know, I'm trying to provide you with resources, right, to give you more things to look at, you know, and then I tried to show here's how we port the content to Python 3, as opposed to just teaching the entire class in Python 3. So as of this year, 2019, all of the content is in Python 3 now. So we made that change. And like I said, I was reluctant to do it, but I did it. And now that I've done it, quite frankly, pretty happy with it. For you guys learning the language, there is a guy on YouTube. His name is The New Boston, all one word. Some people call him Bucky, okay? And what I think you ought to do is you ought to check out his Python 3 tutorial. This is it right here. So I definitely would say check out his Python 3 tutorial. It's a little old, but I still think pretty good. And then my recommendation, I think it's like 50 videos or something like that. Actually, let me look it up right now. Looking at my own video. And it's 56 videos. Okay. So I would say definitely watch that video tutorial. And don't just watch it, actually do it. I think he did a really good job in it. Like I said, it's a little old, but I do think it's pretty good. I would say do the whole video series. And I would try to stay on a pace of like 3 to 4 videos a night. Let's call it 3 nights a week. And let's see how quickly you guys get through it. Let's see you guys write your comments below. For those of you who are actually taking up the challenge and doing these videos, let's see how they go. And I would love to get your feedback, what you think now that you're doing the video series. I think it's really good. I hope you guys do it. And as you're getting through his video series, getting familiar with Python, write in the comments below what you think about it. Like, what are you learning? What do you like? How difficult was it? How hard was it? Talk to me about that, guys. But I think this will be the most helpful to your career, right? Getting familiar with programming. You don't need to be a programmer to be a security person, but you really should be comfortable with the language, right? So you want to be comfortable talking with developers. You want to be comfortable utilizing scripting tools to do things in the security field. Look through log files.
Designated areas only. Please refrain from smoking while walking throughout the building.
All right, well. Smoking is prohibited, I guess we've learned. I think this Python 3 tutorial series that Bucky, the New Boston, does, like I said, it's a little old. And my understanding is he's not making videos anymore. I think he got a job doing something at a startup. But I really think it's really helpful for you. 3 to 4 videos a night, 3 nights a week. Let's see your comments below at how you're doing with his video series. Okay, talk to me about it, and I'll keep coming up with more of these mentor moments, and we'll try and do a little bit better.
Regulations require that baggage must be supervised at all times.
Baggage needs to be supervised at all times. All right, guys, and with that, that's the end of our mentor moment. I hope you guys keep working on Python. Take care. Hey, what's up, InfoSec Addicts? I've got great news. We actually just had one of our mentor students just get a job as a pen tester. So that's so, so, so good. So congratulations to you, Chris. Good job working for the 3 months that you've been a mentor student. I know there was some weeks that sucked doing BWAP and really kind of embracing the suck with the updated version of Burp Suite. But I wanted to let you know I'm so proud of you, man. I'm so happy for you. Congratulations, big ups on getting the job. And I think you did a good job. You did all the right steps. You did the GitHub page, you did the blog, you did the labs every week. You work diligently, man, and I just want to let you know, good job. And then for the rest of you guys who are thinking about mentor-led training, if you do want to talk to any of the current mentees who are working away diligently, I'll be happy to put you in touch with them. Obviously, we'll contact them and let them know first, but you got to hear from the guys who are going through it. This is working. So quick overview of how it works. You'll work with me. We'll do like a skill inventory, kind of figure out what your strengths and weaknesses are. Once we know what your strengths and weaknesses are, then we'll say, okay, well, here's your strengths and weaknesses. And then we'll say, okay, well, what kind of job are you looking for? Penetration tester, malware analysis, reverse engineering, whatever that is. Then after that, we'll set up a custom training program and a schedule. So we set up your training program. Hey, here's what you're going to be working on every week. And then our communication schedule. Communication schedule is just, when are we going to be talking? Once a week, twice a week, 30 minutes, hour, whatever those intervals are. We'll get that figured out, we'll get that worked out, and then what are the goals? So, you know, what are the measurables is what I should say. And then how do we know that you're hitting your goals and are you on target? And we'll be adjusting your training program if necessary, and then you know, we'll just make sure that you get the job that you're looking for, or the skill set that you're looking for, or pass the certification that you're looking to pass, whatever that goal is in terms of cybersecurity. I'm gonna do my absolute best to help you. But again, congratulations. Chris, keep kicking butt. And Robert, Zuman, you guys, Sarika, I got my eye on you. You guys better get your butt in line and keep working. All right. Thanks for checking out our videos here at InfoSec Addicts. Guys, keep looking out for more content, lots of new stuff that we're working on, and see you guys soon.